Good morning, friends. Myself, Professor Varsha Jadhav. Today I am going to deliver lecture on extraction of medicinal plants. Extraction, as this term indicates, that it is the process of removal of active chemical constituents from crude drugs by using the suitable solvents. Now, whatever products we are getting here from the extraction, as such, they are in impure liquid forms. They are either semi-solids or the powder form, and they are used for oral purposes or for the external use. What is the actual principle of extraction? So here, extraction is based upon the mass transfer process. Mass transfer process means whenever the liquid is being used as a menstruum and crude drug is being soaked in that menstruum, at that time, due to the surface contact, the liquid or solvent that will penetrate deep into the cell, and at the same time it dissolves the all active chemical constituents in that solvent. This process is being continued till equilibrium is being developed inside the cell and outside the cell. And after that, the solvent is being removed out from the cell, and at the same time, the menstruum, it will be fully saturated with the active chemical constituents. There are different classes of extraction. First one is the decoction. As such, decoction is the process of removal of active chemical constituents specifically from the plant part, which are very hard in nature. Now, this process is mainly applicable for roots, rhizomes, and the bark. Second one is the infusion. So this process is known as the ready extraction. This process is mainly used for the extraction of powder drugs which are soaked within the solvent like milk, water, for very short duration of the time. After the extraction is being completed, it is being filtered, and whatever is the resulting filtrate, that is immediately consumed by the patients. Next one is the tinctures. Tinctures are nothing but the alcoholic formulations or alcoholic preparations. Next one is the fluid extracts. When extracts are available in liquid forms, they are known as the fluid extracts. Semi-solid extracts. So whatever extracts we are getting from the extraction process, they are concentrated to the pasty mass and they are known as the semi-solid extracts. Next one is the powdered extracts. In the powder extracts, all the extracts, they are being dried by suitable method, and after they are drying, all the solvent is being removed out and finally they are converted into the powders. Such preparations, they are popularly known as the galenicals due to the name of the scientist Galen. The purposes of standardized extraction procedures for crude drugs. They are therapeutically active components, they are being derived through the extraction process, and the resulting menstruum or extragent that is enriched with the active chemical constituents. The extracts thus obtained may be ready for use as medicinal agents in the form of tinctures or fluid extracts. They may be further processed and incorporated in various dosage forms such as tablets, capsules, or other formulations. Sometimes they are fractionated to isolate individual chemical entities. Extraction process is mainly depending upon various factors. Now, which are these factors? First one is the surface of separation of phases. So as much as the surface area is larger, better will be the extraction. Second one is the duration of process. So whenever the powdered crude drug material that is soaked in water for sufficient duration of time, it will give better and efficient separation of active chemical constituents. Next one is the viscosity of menstruum or extragent. So if the menstruum is higher viscous or it is having higher viscosity, at that time it becomes difficult to penetrate this menstruum within the cell core and to extract all the active chemical constituents. So if viscosity is being lower, better will be the extraction. Next one is the temperature. Temperature will facilitate the process of extraction. Next one is the addition of surfactant. So surfactants will reduce interfacial tension in between two phases, and it will helpful for incorporating the menstruum or extragent within the cell core. Next one is the choice of extragents or menstruum. So according to the choice of the analyst or researcher, if he or she want to isolate the polar chemical constituents, at that time polar solvents can be used for extraction like alcohol, water, and if researcher is interested in extraction of non-polar chemical constituents, at that time non-polar solvents can be used as a extragents. Next one is the porosity and size of the cavities. If the crude drug material is porous one, it will facilitate entry of menstruum within the core of that plant material. Next one is the influence and vibrations. So vibrations will helpful for deep penetration of the menstruum within the cell core and extraction of active chemical constituents. Viscosity, how viscosity affects on the extraction of active chemical constituents. So if we are using less viscous solutions, they are having better power to penetrate within the cell core. And if the case is reversed, that means if we are using viscous liquids or viscous menstruum for extraction, the penetration will be lowered one, and as a result you will get poor extraction. Next point, that is the liquefied gases. So liquefied gases like carbon dioxide, propane, butane, liquid ammonia, and other agents are used in an advanced extraction process like supercritical fuel extraction. Hereby you will get a very efficient extracts for crude drugs. Next point, that is the raising of the temperature. It may the process of extraction very faster one, and you will get efficient extraction here. Porosity of the material. As the material is being porous one, it will facilitate entry of the menstruum within the cell core, and after the entry it will solubilize all the active chemical constituents, and at the same time you will get very efficient extraction. What should be the requirements of solvent to ensure completeness of extraction? So very first one is the selectivity. So solvent should be selected as per the choice of analyst. If we want to isolate and if we want to extract the polar chemical constituents, at the same time you have to use the polar solvents. If we are interested in isolation of non-polar chemical constituents, at the same time you can use the non-polar solvents. Next one is the low toxicity and inflammable. So whatever solvent you are choosing here for extraction, it should have low toxicity and it should be inflammable. Next one is the availability and affordable. So the solvent used here, it should be economic one, and the analyst should afford it. Next point, that is the penetration into the pores of crude drug material or through the wall, cell wall. So here for better extraction process or for efficient extraction process, this parameter is very important. Next one is the prevent the development of microflora. This is the case where you are using the water as solvent. Water is very beneficial for growth and development of the microorganism. So whenever you are going for aquatic extraction, at the same time you have to use some of the antiseptic, or you can say alcohol or glycerin, as a solvent to avoid development of microflora in the infusion. Here water is used as a better solvent for extraction. Which are the desired properties of water as a solvent? So first property, it is very well penetrates deep into the cell membrane and it will extract out all the chemical constituents. Next point, that is the it is very common. So you can take water from suitable sources, as it is very common. It is explosion proof. It is available at low cost and it is pharmacologically inert. But though it enjoys this type of the advantages, it is having some disadvantages that it cannot dissolve the hydrophobic material. As such, water don't have antiseptic properties, so chances of development of microorganisms are more in such case. Again, due to the water, hydrolytic reactions or hydrolytic cleavage may occur, and hereby you will not get sufficient or efficient extraction. Enzymes can be active in presence of water, so care should be taken that enzymes should be inactive during this extraction. Second solvent used here is alcohol. It is having some good properties that it is having antiseptic property. It does not allow growth and development of microorganisms in the extracts. The stronger alcohols, they cannot undergo hydrolytic reactions, and that's why you can protect your extracts from these hydrolytic reactions. In presence of alcohol, many of the enzymes, they become inactive. So it is one of the wide choice for analyst and researcher to use it as a solvent. As alcohol is volatile in nature, you can easily dry the extract and you can convert it into the powder form. So this powder extract can be stored for longer duration of time for future purposes. Disadvantages of alcohol. So hereby it is heavier than water, and that's why the penetration of alcohol will be less as compared to the water within the cell core. Second one, it is flammable, and it will immediately catch up the fire, and some accidents will happen in the laboratory. Along with water and alcohol, many other solvents are also used in manufacture of herbal extracts like acetone, ethyl ether, chloroform. Now chloroform, it is used as a nonpolar solvent for extraction of nonpolar chemical constituents like lipidic compounds and the steroids. With this, vegetable oils, liquefied gases, methanol, they are also used as a solvent for extraction of active chemical constituents. Next point, that is the applications of extraction techniques. Extraction is widely used for removal of active chemical constituents such as alkaloids, glycosides, steroids, phenolics, flavonoids, tannins, and many more. It is also helpful for extraction of delicate perfumes. It is also beneficial for extraction of nucleotides, proteins and the amino acids. It is also helpful for extraction of plant pigments. Thank you.